I got my hands on these two reeling cameras, one with optical zoom and one without, as well as this reeling 2TB 8-port NVR. As you may guess, I will set these things up and I'll compare the cameras. But that is not enough for me. I will also try to add them in Blue Iris and Home Assistant using OnViv and RTSP. Coming up! What's up, Kirill Pajaskis here. You will see a security camera battle between the Reolink RLC520 and RLC522 with optical zoom connected to Reolink NVR versus Blue Iris and Home Assistant. Let's get ready to rumble! I'm kidding, this video will not be a fight, but more likely a demonstration of the available options that will help you choose the best option for you. And if you don't have the same cameras and NVR, don't go away, because most of the things will work with every OnViv and RTSP enabled camera out there. So I will show you how to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. I'm kidding again. Now seriously, first you will see what it is like to have cameras and hardware NVR from the same brand. Second, if you decide to go with cameras and software NVR like Blue Iris. And third, if you want to have them both, hardware NVR and some software like Home Assistant, Blue Iris, MotionEye, and so on and so on, just like me. I will also show you the difference between camera with and without zoom somewhere in the middle of the video. Now, let's start this. Let's see what is inside the box of the Reolink NVR. HDMI cable. And here it is, the NVR itself. 2TB, 8 ports, LAN cable, eSATA, VGA, HDMI to set up the device, USB, 4D mouse, on and off button and audio out, and DC 48 volts. If you choose to have hardware NVR and cameras, Reolink provide everything you need in the package. That includes 2TB of storage for this 8-port NVR, and they also give you a mouse, several adapters and HDMI cable. I really like that, because several expensive TVs are not including HDMI cable in their packaging. But that is not the case here. You have everything. Just plug and play. And this is the Reolink RLC522 5 megapixel camera. Let's see what's inside the box. Do not accept this if seal is broken. Okay, that seal is not broken. I will break it now. A manual with stickers, LAN cable, protective foam, and a camera. Here it is. Up button, power connector, and power over Ethernet RJ45 connector. This can be moved. And this is the mounting bracket that you can put on the ceiling or on the wall. And the hardest part when choosing this approach with hardware NVR and cameras from one brand is deciding where to put the cameras and how to cable them beautifully. It is recommended to connect the NVR and the cameras up front to test if everything is okay. And I'm doing exactly that. I will show you. I just connected the NVR. This is the power cable. This is the mouse. This is the HDMI cable. This is the LAN. And this is the cable that are going to the camera 1 and camera 2. So I will switch this NVR on and we will see what will happen. Reolink. Link your real world. Okay, I'll link it. I'm hearing some noise from the cameras. Admin. Password. Admin enable password. Next. So I click finish. And here it is. I have two cameras. One with zoom and one without. Maybe I have to remove this sticker. Something that should happen right away. I managed to do it for 2 minutes at least. Finally. Okay. Good quality, very good quality. I don't know which camera is which. So I'm just trying to zoom in. And I guess I choose the right one from the first time. I'll quickly show you how to add the NVR to the Reolink app. Here it is. I'll click on the plus button and I'll scan the barcode located in the upper right corner. And all the channels, as you can see, are now visible, and there is a label asking me to enter username and the password. So I'll do that. And the name is already visible, but not the stream. I don't know why. Loading the stream, here it is. It is working. If you decide to go with RTSP enabled camera like these two and software NVR, you need an always on computer with good CPU and enough memory, as well as storage for your camera's footage. You also need to get the camera's RTSP link and credentials in order to add them to the software NVR. Here is how you can do that in Blue Iris. This is the Blue Iris interface. It is considered one of the best software NVRs available these days. And this is how you can add cameras to it. Just click on the plus button and paste the RTSP link inside. My RTSP link consists of username, password, the IP of my NVR. The default RTSP port is 554. If you don't have NVR, you just have to replace this IP with your RTSP enabled camera right here. And this here is the mainstream of the first channel of the NVR. This is the substream with lower resolution, but I'll get the mainstream. And I'll copy this. And I'll just paste it right here. And I'll click somewhere else. Blue Iris is smart enough and it will get the IP from the RTSP link, the username, the password, the path, everything. And I'll just have to click OK and OK again. And here it is. The camera is working. This is the RLC 520. I can add the 5-2 RLC camera exactly the same way. I just have to copy this RTSP link. Again, copy, paste here, click somewhere else, OK, and OK again. The streams are now working, but not the zoom. Only if I open a camera and use the mouse, I can digitally zoom the picture. And because the camera resolution is pretty good, I can read what is the book title. Also, if I go to camera properties, I can enable the motion. But I believe this is done on the Blue Iris part, because if you enable this, the motion, the CPU goes up a bit, quite a bit actually. So this is not coming from the camera itself, it's done probably in Blue Iris.
I can also add Reolink NVR to Blue Iris using ONVIF, but I get only the first channel, that means first camera. If you manage to add all connected cameras to the NVR using ONVIF, let me know in the comments how you managed to do that.
The default port is 8000 for the Reolink cams. And I'll click inspect now. Close, OK, OK. And this will add my camera that is connected on the first NVR channel. In that case, it's RLC 520. And as you can see, zoom in and zoom out button are now clickable, because if I click on these two cameras added with the RTSP link, this is great.
but here it is working. Probably if my first camera, the camera connected to my first NVR port was 5-2 cam with optical zoom, probably these buttons are going to work. Again, I cannot add the second camera using the OMVIF approach at the moment.
And this is how you can add a Reolink RLC 520 and Reolink RLC 522 to Home Assistant using OMVIF.
This is a brand new Home Assistant installation installed using Home Assistant supervised method. You can find more info in this video how to do that if you wish. I'll open it and I'll click on Configuration, Integrations, big orange plus button, and I'll search for OMVIF. And I'll click on it, Submit. I'll type a name here, NVR. The IP of my NVR is this one. The port for Reolink cams and NVR is 8000. And I'll click Submit. Username is admin, password is QWERTY UI, submit, and here it is, NVR is added. I can add it to area if I wish, but I don't want to do that, and I'll click finish. And as you can see,
hey, if you're new here, consider subscribing. You can do that right now by hit the subscribe button and notification bell. Now let's continue.
I added one OMVIF device and 16 entities. And if I go to the overview, I will see my streams already added right here on the dashboard. This is 520. The stream is also working pretty good, I believe. This is 522, and this is my wireless Reolink cam automatically added. This is RLC 410W. You can add this camera to your Reolink NVR as well without any issues. And the stream is working fine as well. If for some reason these streams are not automatically added to your Home Assistant, you can easily add them by click on Configure UI, plus button, picture, glance, and for camera entity, you can see your streams here. I'll click the first one. You can add additional sensors here, like the sun, for example. And I can click save. And this is my new card.
Maybe you don't want to record everything. Instead, you want to take a look at the streams from time to time and to create some automations when motion is detected. Unfortunately, I didn't manage to get the camera's motion sensors as well as zoom button in Home Assistant. It is very strange because I see a lot of entities in the OMVIF integration that should be the sensors, but when I click on them, they are gone. It is probably a bug or something that I hope it will be fixed. Let me know if you managed to make this work in the comments. To zoom or not to zoom, to pay 40 euros more or to save them, or in other words, to buy a Reolink RLC 522 with optical zoom or a Reolink RLC 520 without. Let's check this out.
And this is the Reolink NVR web interface. You can open it by just type the IP address of the NVR in a browser. And here you have to type your username and password to log in. This is the first channel, the first camera. I will mute it in order not to hear loud noises. This is the second camera, 522. And as you can see here, because the camera has optical zoom, there is additional controls that are not available on the camera without optical zoom, that's RLC 520. This menu is missing here. And if I go back, I can demonstrate you the optical zoom. Here it is. This is the 3x optical zoom. and zoom out. This is the playback where you can see your records in the past. You can define a date, time, and play the footage. And this is the RLC 520 in complete darkness. Let me check the RLC 522 camera again in the same room. And this is the zoom. Few seconds to focus. The labels are readable. Very good.
Any sort of engagement on this channel does really help a lot with the YouTube algorithm. So you make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Also, feel free to add me on Twitter by searching for this username. I'm trying to post there frequently. You can also find me on my Discord server as well. If you want to become one of my supporters, you can see exactly how in the video description below. I really hope that you find this information useful and you now know what to choose for your home. Hardware NVR and cameras from Wembrandt like these from Reelink, or RTSP and ONVIF enabled cameras and software NVR like Blue Iris, and as addition Home Assistant. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart but not hard. Thank you for watching, see you next time!